Investors still trying to figure out when the Fed will raise rates, but our next guest says it isn't happening this year and may very well not happen until 2020. What could this mean for gold? Joining us now is Jeff Opdyke, executive editor of the popular newsletter Total Wealth Insider. Jeff, thanks so much for joining us on Kitco's Gold Report.
Hey, no worries. Thanks for having me.
So let's talk about that Fed rate hike. Markets are pricing in about a 24% chance of a hike in September, but you think they got it all wrong. Why is that?
You know, what the market thinks is going to happen is honestly totally irrelevant, because the market has been saying there's going to be a Fed rate hike just about every Fed meeting now, it seems like, since about 2013. And I've been saying since May of 2012 that there is absolutely no way the Fed has the capacity to raise rates. And I think that going into the September meeting, the chance of a Fed rate hike is zero. You know, the chance of a Fed rate hike in December is zero. The chance of a Fed rate hike until sometime in the 2020s is probably zero, because there's too many external events that we have to deal with that have absolutely nothing to do with what everybody's worried about, inflation or the jobs market. Those two data points do not make an economy, and they do not say anything about the Fed's capacity to raise interest rates.
But Jeff, can the Fed afford to not raise rates? Wouldn't it lose all credibility at this point?
What credibility? The Fed has no credibility. The Fed hasn't had credibility since Alan Greenspan. And they've done a horrible job of managing its economy and managing the U.S. currency and managing the monetary policy of America. But the reality of the situation is it's not whether or not the Fed can or cannot raise interest rates, lose credibility, et cetera. You have to look at where the United States is and where the world is. Since 2007, 2008, since the end of the financial crisis, the global economy has taken on literally trillions of dollars of excess debt or extra debt. The U.S. government has taken on trillions of dollars of extra debt, and we're now $20 trillion in debt. It's double where we were in 2007. The question becomes, once you start raising interest rates, that has a knock-on effect on the U.S. dollar. Suddenly, if you raise interest rates again, we are well above any major currency in the world outside the Australians and the New Zealands of the world, and they're such minor currencies, they're sort of irrelevant. So when you compare the U.S. dollar to the euro, the yen, the British pound, our interest rates would be so much higher than those places that you'd have more money flowing into the dollar. The dollar gets even stronger. That begins to destroy the U.S. economy because all of the impacts it has on the S&P 500 companies who have suddenly are seeing their sales and profits go away. You know, the S&P right now is seven quarters into negative growth in operating income. All right, seven quarters. That's the worst in at least 20 years. It's partly because of the U.S. dollar. The dollar has gotten so strong it's hurt the Boeings of the world and the Microsofts of the world and the Harley Davidsons of the world, or at least of the Americas. So you can't just go out and say, okay, well, the Fed needs to raise interest rates to preserve credibility. The Fed needs to raise interest rates because the jobs market is finally we're at full employment. I'll come back to that in a second. And the Fed needs to raise rates because, oh, they've got to worry about inflation. If the Fed raises rates, they have to worry about the knock-on effects of all this external debt that exists in the world these days that is dollar-denominated. Because if that stuff starts rising, right, suddenly the capacity of America to repay its debts, and more importantly, the capacity of emerging markets to repay those debts, suddenly is called into question. And when that happens, you're going to get a crisis around the world.
So, Jeff, with the time we have left, let's talk about gold and silver and what this means for the metals. The gold obviously trading inversely to rate hike expectations here. Is this just the beginning of a longer-term bull run for gold and possibly silver here?
Absolutely, and I am not some sort of dyed-in-the-wool, gold bug. I just see gold today as a pure insurance policy. It's not an investment at this point. It is pure insurance against the Federal Reserve or some central bank or some government losing control of the apple cart. I fully expect we are going to see at some point a complete financial reset in the Western economies, and it's going to be tied to some degree in gold. It always has been throughout history. This time is going to be no different.
Well, we will both be at the Total Wealth Symposium next week where you are a speaker. So tell us a little bit of what we can expect to hear from the conference and what you would like to teach investors to protect their wealth in the current environment.
Yeah, what I'm going to be talking about largely is, you know, what we just talked about, and it's the idea that we are in the midst of a historic moment when there are bubbles all over the place, bubbles in currency, bubble in debt, bubbles in the stock markets. It's incredible. And bubbles in the house price. Again, we're back in at highs with the Schiller home prices. So when we start getting to a point where bubbles start popping again, it's going to be substantially more dramatic than it was in 2007-08 because the world is in a worse place than it was in 2007-08. Too big to fail is actually bigger now than it was.
All right, Jeff. Well, I look forward to seeing you next week at the conference. Thanks for joining us today.
Thanks a lot.
And stay tuned for our coverage from the Total Wealth Symposium, which starts next week. In the meantime, thanks for watching this edition of Kitco's Gold Report. We'll see you tomorrow.